In a far-off kingdom where logic was as powerful as swords, there ruled a wise yet cunning king. His love for puzzles and riddles was known far and wide. He believed the key to true wisdom lay not in a brute strength, but in the power of the mind. One day, the king's attention turned to a famous mathematician in the kingdom. A man whose genius had earned him both admiration and envy. The king, ever eager to test the limits of human intellect, devised a plan. In the dark of night, the king's guards captured the mathematician's only son. The next morning, the mathematician was summoned to the palace, where the king sat on his grand throne, a devious smile on his face.
"I have your son,"
the king said, his voice booming through the hall.
"If you wish to see him free, you must solve a puzzle for me."
The mathematician's heart sank, but he knew there was no turning back. The king continued,
"I have 10 bags. You must distribute stones among the bags however you wish. When I ask for any specific number of stones, from 0 to 1,000, you must be able to hand me the exact number, using some combination of those bags. You can place as many stones as you like in any bag, but each bag must hold no more than 1,000 stones. If you fail, your son will remain my prisoner forever."
The mathematician closed his eyes and thought deeply. This was no ordinary riddle. He needed to be clever, for the king was known to find any loophole.
"But,"
the king added, a gleam in his eye,
"you will only have 3 minutes to answer each request."
The mathematician felt his pulse quicken. Time was not on his side. He was given a short window to think, and soon an idea sparked his mind. When the time came, the king called out his first request.
"Give me exactly 562 stones.
With only seconds to spare, the mathematician handed the king a combination of bags that held the exact number of stones. The court, waiting on edge, exhaled in relief as the king accepted the solution. Then, the king asked for a second number.
"Give me 879 stones.
Once again, with the clock ticking down, the mathematician calmly handed over the correct bags. The court was amazed when he met the challenge again. But the king's eyes narrowed. He was impressed, but not ready to admit defeat. For his final test, the king gave mathematician the most challenging number he could think of.
"Give me 999 stones.
The mathematician, now fully in his element, swiftly calculated in his mind and handed over the precise bags with moments to spare. The court fell silent, waiting for the king's reaction. After a tense pause, the king smirked, unwilling to concede yet.
"One last challenge,"
he declared, raising his hand for silence.
"Give me 1,022 stones. You have only 3 minutes.
A hush fell over the room. The mathematician's heart raced. The king had thrown in a final surprise. One last, unexpected number, just when the mathematician thought the puzzle was over. But the mathematician had already grasped the full power of his method. With mere seconds on the clock, he handed over the bags containing exactly 1,022 stones. The court erupted in gasps of astonishment as the king for the first time looked stunned. After a tense moment, the king threw back his head and laughed.
"You have done it, mathematician. 4 times you have succeeded where others would have failed. I grant you your son's freedom."
As the guards released his son, the mathematician bowed to the king, knowing that he had outwitted the most powerful ruler in the land, not with strength, but with the brilliance of his mind. The mathematician and his son left the palace free at last. But as they walked away, the mathematician couldn't help but smile to himself. He knew that even the cleverest of kings was no match for the power of mathematics. Alright, so how did mathematicians solve this seemingly impossible task? Well, if you want to try to answer this question for yourself, you can pause the video right now, you can rewind the story, and then come back and check the solution. Alright, so let's solve this one. So first, we're going to start with the fact that we have 10 bags. We also know that we have enough stones at our disposal because the king said that we can put 1,000 stones in each bag. So we can safely assume that there is more than 10,000 stones to work with. Next, let's see how did our mathematician distribute those stones. We're going to try to use the same logic as him. So basically, we have to be ready for any number of stones until 1,000. So this means that in our first bag, our mathematician needs to put one stone first. Then, in the second bag, he needs to put two stones to cover for this number. Then, you may say that in the third bag, we need to put three stones. Well, this is actually a wrong assumption. Because the king said that we can use the combination of any bags. So, to get the three stones, we can just add the bag number one and bag number two, and we will get three stones. So, this means that in our third bag, we have to put four stones. Alright, so we are going to continue by using the same logic. So, we are not going to put 5 stones in the fourth bag because we can combine bag number 1 and 3 to get to 5 stones. We are also not going to put 6 stones because we can combine second and the third bag, which will give us 6 stones. And finally, we are not going to put 7 stones because we can combine all 3 bags to get to 7 stones. So, this means that in our fourth bag, we need to put 8 stones. So now we can use the same logic and fill all remaining bags. So in the fifth bag, we will have to put 16 stones, then 32 stones, then 64, then 128, 256, and finally in the last bag, we have to put 512 stones. Alright, but you may wonder, is this enough to get us to 1,000 stones? Well, actually it is. Because if you add all the bags together, you will see that you will get to 1,023 stones, which is actually more than enough for us. Okay, so this should be our solution, but before we check this solution, let me just tell you one interesting fact about all numbers in our bags. You may probably already noticed that all those numbers represent the powers of number 2. So, if we take a look at the first bag with the value of 1, we can substitute 1 with 2 to the power of 0. In the second bag, we can substitute 2 with 2 to the power of 1. Then we can substitute number 4 with 2 to the power of 2. Then 8 with 2 to the power of 3. And so on and so forth until 2 to the power of 9. Alright, so now let's head back and try to see if this really works out for us. So let's first remind ourselves which number did King ask first. So he said,
"Give me exactly 562 stones."
Alright, so in order for our mathematician to get to number 562, only thing that he needs to do is to take the bag with the biggest but lesser number than 562. So, in our case, this will be bag with 512 stones. Now, the mathematician only needs to know subtraction. So, if we subtract 562 and 512, we will get 50 stones. So, this means that we owe our king 50 more stones. So now we're going to continue with this logic. We're going to take the next number, which is less than 50, and this number will be number 32. So we're going to take the bag with 32 stones. Now, if we subtract 50 and 32, we're going to see that we need 18 stones more. So we're going to take the next bag, and that is the bag with 16 stones. So 18 minus 16 will get us to 2 stones, and this means that we have to take the bag with 2 stones. And there you go, this is the combination of 4 bags which our mathematician handled to the king. Okay, what about the second task? For the second task, the king said,
"Give me 879 stones."
Alright, your majesty, so we're going to use the same principle. First, we're going to take the bag with the biggest number of stones, but lesser than 879, and this is obviously the bag with 512 stones. Now we're going to subtract this and get 367. Then, we're going to take next bag with 256 stones, subtract this, and we're going to get 111 stones left. So, we cannot take the bag with 128 stones, because then we will overshoot the number. So, we're going to take the bag with 64 stones. Subtract this, and you'll get 47 stones left. Then, we will take the bag with 32 stones, subtract, and get 15 stones left. We're not going to take the bag with the 16 stones, because then we will overshoot. So, we're taking the bag with 8 stones, subtract, then we're going to take the bag with 4 stones, then subtract, then the bag with 2 stones, and when we subtract this, we're going to owe only 1 stone, so we're going to take the bag with 1 stone, and there you go, this is the combination of 8 bags which our mathematician handled to the king. Okay, so what about the third task? In third task, the king said,
"Give me 999 stones."
Alright, so for this final task, well, it's basically the same principle as before, so we are going to follow the same steps, and as you can see, if we do this, our mathematician will end up with this combination of 8 bags, and of course, you can check it out for yourself. But, if you remember, the king had one final request. The one which actually should let mathematician to fail. In this one, the king said,
"Give me 1,022 stones."
As you can see, for this one, king broke his own rules. He wanted to trick our mathematician by asking for the number greater than 1,000. But luckily for us, as we said earlier, if we add all the stones in all bags, we will get to 1,023 stones. So this means that our mathematician have just enough stones to indulge the king's request. So this basically means that he will have to take all the bags at our disposal, except the first bag with 1 stone, and he will get to 1,022 stones, and he has solved the king's request. Now, let me tell you one more really interesting thing about the numbers inside the bags. If you arrange those numbers in line, you can see that we will actually get something that's called a geometric progression. A geometric progression, also known as geometric sequence, represents a mathematical sequence of non-zero numbers where each term after the first is found by multiplying the previous one by a fixed number, which we call a common ratio. So, in our case here, you can see that we can get the next term inside our progression by multiplying the previous term with 2. So this means that 2 is actually common ratio. And there's a really interesting formula from which we can calculate the sum of definite terms inside the geometric progression. It looks something like this, where A stands for the first term, R stands for common ratio, N stands for number of terms, and Sn is actually the sum of n terms. But I just want to mention one thing, this formula only works if our common ratio is greater than 1, which it is in our case. So, let's substitute our values here. our first term will actually be 1, because we have 1 stone in the first bag. Then our common ratio is 2. The number of terms will actually represent the number of bags at our disposal, and the sum of n terms will actually be the maximum number of stones that we can get from this combination of bags. This is really interesting, because if we substitute all those values into the formula, we will get the following relation: that the maximum number of stones is equal to the 2 to the power of number of bags minus 1. And this is such an awesome relation, because with this formula, we can actually calculate the maximum number of stones which we can handle to the king from the number of bags that we have. So, in our case here, we had 10 bags. So, 2 to the power of 10 minus 1 will be equal to, well, you guessed it, 1023 stones. So, this is the maximum number of stones which we can combine with 10 bags. Alright, so I really hope you guys enjoyed this interesting mathematical puzzle. If you did, I would like to encourage you to smash the like button and consider subscribing to the channel for more content like this in the future. And of course, until next time, see you all and take care.